haters come from? No. Serious. Everything that black people do, there's a historical reference, but they'll never teach you this. Let me tell you why black people hate on each other. When they had us as slaves, if one slave would escape the plantation, guess what they would do to every other slave? Be saying it, dear, I ain't got much money, but you done had a rest. It's dollars. No, I said 20. Did you say it? Okay. They would beat them nearly nothing. No, you already had some money. You're smart anyway. Give me my money back. No, but she didn't ask the question. No, don't give it to her. Make her earn it. But listen, they would beat nearly every slave to death. So you know what happened? All the slaves started being mad at any slave that would escape. So that's the reason why it is the way. Think about it. If somebody's selling dope in our neighborhood or they just came to jail, what do our people do? We applaud them. Mm-hmm. But if somebody go to college or somebody, you know, get out or somebody does something great, right, you think they're better than somebody. And if somebody's smart in our community, the first thing they say, you trying to act white. Instead of you just being smart. But that has been programmed. You have to look at them with love because you are smarter than they are. One more question, I gotta go. Well, I ain't gotta go, but we gotta give it up to the other grown-ups. No, another one. I know. Bro, we gotta give it to these kids. Oh.
That's a question that I want to answer when we're in a group alone. I think some questions that we shouldn't answer in open forums, because especially with me being an entertainer, I've been sued and people try to put me in jail for my opinions. I have a different opinion than most people. I believe the reason why police do our children the way that they do, it's because the parents allowed them to. If any other race of people, they treated people like that, then those people do something. Or those people organize. Or those people boycott. Or those people do something. A lot of people get mad at me because I don't run around anymore like I used to when another black person gets killed. You know why I don't? Because I always say God ain't gonna do nothing. I sit up here and I put my life on the line. But we as a race of people don't care about our children. Because if we really cared about our children, we would be willing to die for them if they are innocent in their actions, and we're not. So as a community, until we truly care about our children and are willing to stand, live, and die for them, they will continue dying. And they will continue to be getting treated the way that they are, because grown-ups don't really care. I gotta go. Now turn it over to the rest of the people. I'm not going nowhere. I'm not scared of it. I'll be walking around. You can come talk to me. You can come buy some stuff from me, t-shirts and all that kind of stuff. You can come here. Y'all don't worry about me talking about grown-ups. We don't make the grown-ups go. But I want to tell you something in closing. Listen to me, okay? I want to tell y'all something. This is the truth. It is very, very, very lonely as a grown-up. It is very, very lonely when you live in being right. Because as much as these grown-ups tell you all to be right, what kind of television shows do they put on TV for you to watch? What kind of video games do they make for you to buy? Exactly, and I love GTA. I really do. I sit up here and talk to you as soon as I get done. You know too much, huh? There ain't no level. There ain't no levels on GTA. Come on, brother, try to play me like I'm stupid. But let me tell y'all, I actually make music for games. Have any of y'all played Marvel vs. Capcom? Yeah, like I made the music for the very first commercials for that. Yeah, I did. So listen to me. Listen to me in closing. It is very lonely when you do the right thing. But I'm going to tell you something.
And this is the only thing I wanted to tell you all about conflict resolution. This is what I realized about violence. Whenever you are in a situation, you mind if I use you? I don't mean any disrespect. Just come on. I'm just stand up for a minute. So, I like you about to jump on me. Okay, you're very aggressive. Don't do that again. Stand up. So, this is how I look at people whenever it's time for me to get in conflict. Because I used to be the type of rapper that I would fight all the time. As a matter of fact, as I talked to you all about conflict resolution, I, a year ago, got arrested. Because somebody did something that I thought was very disrespectful to me, and I was right in what I did, but let me tell you what I think about it. Although I was right, I still ended up going to jail, still ended up paying $2,500, I still ended up being on TMZ, and everybody talked about me, and I got all these big businesses that ended up being affected. Whenever you're in conflict and it's not threatening your life, look at them in terms of money. Look at them in terms of success. Not saying you, but let's just say you, somebody else, sit down, because I don't want to use you, because sometimes it feel like I'm projecting that at you. But I look at people's worth. Are you worth me getting in trouble? Are you worth me not fulfilling my destiny? Are you worth me not graduating and being able to move on to the next level of life? In most cases, I hug them. I am a dude, you right, I'm wrong, I'm sorry. And then guess what? I'm still David Banner. I still make more money than you. Tomorrow when I wake up, I'm going to a movie set. 9 times out of 10, you're going to get in trouble. And what I realize about people who usually start conflict, that is what they do. So they're gonna end up running into the wrong person and getting exactly what they should get, and you won't have anything to do with it. Ludacris was actually one of the people that taught me that. I was gonna go and put my hands on somebody one day, and I called Luda, and Luda told me, "You're David Banner." And I was like, "Hey, I'm David. I just thought about something. I was giving them all that money. I gotta pay you with that." "Oh, well, I got you. Hey, let me borrow $20, Lord. I gotta play the brothers. The brothers gonna play my damn bread." But listen. So when you look at somebody, make sure you know what you want. In most cases, when we have conflict, it's because we also don't know what we want in life, and we don't feel any worth in ourselves. Okay? All right? All right? You sure? All right. So I'm about to get a mic over to the panel, right? But I need you all to make me feel good for traveling this far, okay? My name is David Banner, and I thank you. I come from Jackson, Mississippi. I'm from Jackson, Mississippi, from a place that's called Queens. That's where I'm from, that's where I grew up. You know what I'm talking about? The God Box. They call me the God Box. Nah, I changed my life. Thank y'all, I appreciate y'all.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. David. I appreciate you. So Mr. David Banner came from a very long way. He gave us some very practical, great information. Now I want to turn it over to the panel that are these individuals are actually here in the city. So all those ideas that he gave you that spurred up in your mind, the individuals that are on this panel right now, these are the people that you can partner with to actually help those things manifest. And what I want to do real quick is introduce the panel, and then we'll go from there. We have IMDb Chief Roach. We have, you can clap if you want to, that's fine. We have a mother, Sabrina Stanetti. Now she is incremental in this movement of I am my brother's keeper, I am my sister's keeper. We have Nikisha Tober, she's a counselor. We have Peyton Morgan, a representative of one of my teenagers, as well as, I'm going to mess her name up, I apologize, Tayshaun Harris, who's also a teenager. We definitely appreciate that as well. So what I want to do now is we have, she can have to leave very shortly. So the questions that I ask you guys to write down, remember I said write down 2 or 3 questions. I want us to get questions that are directed to the chief first, because we want to maximize the time while he's here. And then from there, what I want us to do is be able to ask these questions really to the panel. And we have Diane Foreman, who's going to be over at that mic right over there. If you have questions, and then you can come right over here to this mic, and we'll get you taken care of. So I will open it up right now. Some of the questions at hand is talking about, you know, your background, your experience in conflict resolution, and some other questions about this violence, what are some of the causes of violence, and some of the practices that we could put in place in order to make that happen. So at this time, if you have a question, come on up to the mic. That line starts right here.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing just fine. I got a few questions. All right, so for a young black man in, you know, the world today, when dealing with an aggressive police officer,